Cavala, Dean of the College of Arts and Humanities here at Cal State Dominguez Hills, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to a wonderful evening of song and drums and performances by folks from all around the community, and it's going to be really, really an exciting evening. This past semester, we have been thinking a lot about the incarceration of Japanese Americans and the executive order that happened 75 years ago that made that, you know, possible. And we've had things like field trips to Manzanar, we've done day-long symposium, we had a number of guest speakers. And this evening, we're sort of culminating that semester-long experience with a group of performers who are going to do everything from play taiko drums to have a world premiere. We're going to have youth choruses sing. We're going to have a play. And so it's really an exciting way to end this, really semester-long commemoration of this important event in American history. So I want to thank you all for coming out. I think you're going to really enjoy the evening. And I want to just make a quick shout out to Mary Au, who did most of the work in organizing this event. Thank you, Mary. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. will say goodbye to all we've ever had. Alone, where we have walked together, I remember April, I'd be glad. I'll be content. You'll love me once in April. Your lips were warm and loved, and spring.
It's as simple as
brothers, mom and pop, and sis and bud, to peer and cheer when I love you and you love me. No place to park and watch the moon go down. We can't take in a picture show or window shop the town. We must do our romancing with lots of people glancing. We don't care, just let them stare and let them frown. The mess hall can be dinner at the Ritz while you lay your corsage. Since gas is rationed, we must walk a bit, but we could pretend our Buick is stored in camouflage. So we'll go on and do the best we can. You're still my favorite glamour girl, and I'm your other fan. It's just as good to pretend it's not so important when you're sure it's true that I love you. I think you know it, and I'll show it when I can.
There is nothing more sorrowful than war. Here alone, all of life's sadness is brought together.
Thank you.
children chasing dragonflies. Their teeth are white.
Warms one up. It did.
purple.
Sends us greetings. From the window of despair, hey sky, there is always tomorrow.
Thank you. To the jungle?
Ah, too bugs.
To the Arctic?
Ah, too cold.
To the desert?
Too hot, too dry.
Maybe you'd just like to wander. Maybe you'd rather just stay here.
Travel is expensive.
The buses.
The trains. The
hotels.
Eating every meal out. You can't get tea like this out of the road. Lovely tea. Lovely matcha.
Obata mailed it from Japan.
We interrupt this program to bring you a special news bulletin. The Japanese have attacked Pearl Harbor, Hawaii by air. President Roosevelt has just announced.
The day of infamy!
The day of infamy?
The day of infamy! Executive Order number 9066. Whereas the successful prosecution of the war requires every possible protection against espionage, against sabotage to national defense.
National defense?
Actified by Section 4, Act of April 20th, 1940, Section 533, as amended by the Act of November 30th, 1940, 54, Section 1220, and the Act of August 21st, 1941, 55, Section 655. United States Code Telephone to Section 104. By virtue of the authority vested in me as the President of the United States, I hereby authorize and direct the Secretary of War to take such steps and to prescribe military areas in such places and in such discretion as he may deem advisable, to exclude any or all persons. The right of any person to enter, remain in, or leave shall subject to whatever discretion the Secretary of War, the appropriate military commander, may impose in his discretion. I hereby further authorize and direct the Secretary of War to take such other steps as he may deem advisable to enforce compliance with the restrictions, including the use of federal troops.
Federal troops.
This order shall not be seen as limiting or modifying in any way the authority prescribing regulations for the conduct and control of alien enemies. Franklin D. Roosevelt, the White House, February 19th, 1942.
Alien enemies?
Alien enemies.
And federal troops! Pack your bags! Western Defense Command and 4th Army Wartime Civil Control Administration, Presidio of San Francisco, California, May 3rd, 1942. Instructions to all persons of Japanese ancestry living in the following area. All of that portion of the city of Los Angeles, state of California, within that boundary, beginning at the point at which Alameda Street meets East 1st Street, then westerly to North Central Avenue, then northerly to the exterior of the Guest of Contemporary at the Museum of Contemporary Art, and then again easterly to Alameda Street. Pursuant to the provisions of Civilian Exclusion Order Number 33, at this headquarters, dated May 3rd, 1942, all persons of Japanese ancestry, both alien and non-alien, will be evacuated from the above area by 12 p.m. Pacific Western Time, Saturday, May 9th, 1942. Oh, you're an alien. You're an enemy. You're an alien. Oh, you're fine. You're an alien. You're an enemy. Oh, you're fine. Alien, enemy, you're fine. And you are, oh, you're fine. Now put down your bags. Put them down. It's not allowed. Throw over your limit. Put them on the ground. Put them on the ground. I said put them on the ground. I said, pick up your bags. Pick up your bags, you're fine. Here, take this. Give it a good home. Come on, take it. It's a bargain. It's a steal. Enjoy it. Learn some gratitude, huh?
Dresser.
The nightstand.
The pillows.
The bed.
The closet.
The shoes. My shoes.
Oh, my shirts.
My plates.
My knives.
My hashi.
Your teapot.
My teapot.
I brought your teapot.
Oh, my teapot.
the tea.
Dust in my hair.
Dust in my eyes.
Dust.
Just dust.
Who knew we'd grow up to be Okies?
I'll go sleep in a chicken coop, better than
melting walls.
These tar-covered walls.
Heat.
Damn heat stroke.
Language.
Darn heat stroke.
Darn sun.
Too much in the sky, damn light.
Darn light.
Darn dark.
Except for when the moon's out.
Darn moon. I feel like it's watching. Darn eye holes of the stars.
Stars. Stars.
Don't you dare find beauty in this.
Well, what about the rainbow?
Oh, rainbow.
After the rain?
No rain, no water, just dust.
No water to wash. No water to bathe.
Call that bathing?
No walls between shower heads.
Don't look.
No walls between toilets.
Tell them not to look.
They do, or they hide their eyes.
Hard to look.
Always.
Your job.
Somebody's got to have one.
Time.
So much time.
They have time.
Shh.
Darn time.
So much time. So many hours.
Should do something with them.
Like what?
Be patriotic.
The flag?
The breeze.
What breeze?
In my mind.
Breeze feels good?
In my mind.
You think guards curse the heat?
Ask him. He's right over
here. Here. Excuse me, sir. Do you have
questions around here? I'm here to assess your fitness for military service. Name?
Sacho Nomura.
Address?
2956 Smart Street, Los Angeles.
Relatives in the U.S.?
Yes.
Relatives in Japan? Relatives
yes.
in Japan! Have you ever been convicted in court of a criminal offense?
I'm sorry, what?
Have you ever been convicted in court of a criminal offense?
No. No.
Accounts in foreign banks?
No.
Investments in foreign companies?
No.
List any contributions you have made to any organization, society, or club.
I've been using the YMCA.
What else?
The Kiwanis Club?
What else?
Nothing else, sir.
List any magazines or newspapers to which you subscribe or which you customarily read?
Nothing really.
Is that nothing or nothing really?
Nothing, sir.
To the best of your knowledge, was your birth ever registered with a Japanese governmental agency for the purpose of establishing Japanese citizenship?
I don't think so.
You think or you know?
To the best of my... No.
Have you ever applied for repatriation to Japan?
No.
Are you willing to serve in the armed services of the United States in combat duty wherever ordered? Answer the question, are you willing to serve in the armed services of the United States?
No!
I didn't quite catch that.
No, I am not willing to serve in the armed services of the United States in combat duty wherever ordered.
Will you swear unqualified allegiance to the United States of America and faithfully defend the United States from any or all attack by foreign or domestic forces, and forswear any form of allegiance or obedience to the Japanese Emperor or any other foreign power, government, or organization?
No.
I see. You're gonna miss the food around here.
Where are you taking me?
With the rabble rousers, learn from obedience. Sachiko pours two cups of tea from her pot. She wakes alone. She drinks her tea alone. She shifts in her seat. In her body. She's breathing now.
Need sugar.
Kind of fair.
Brenda said she'd bring stuff.
Brenda did bring stuff. furniture across the res. Get it yourself.
Thanks.
See, manners. Friend.
Sam.
Great talk.
What's with the tea?
I got it from a woman who lived here before.
A Jap?
No, a Mexican. Yeah, Jap. This was a concentration camp, dummy. Uncle Sam had all the Japs working for free. Putting up buildings, digging irrigation, all of it, so he could keep us Indians here in the middle of nowhere for the rest of our lives.
Uncle Sam knows how to cut a deal.
Woman said this tea ceremony kept the family together. It's a ritual, community, a way to connect. She said since we have to stay, we need it more than they do. Been a while. Mom wants you to come over tomorrow. Time to pitch in, now you're back.
I'm done with sheep.
Sheep aren't done with you.
I've got military experience now.
What will you do, Mr. Military Experience?
Now my buddy Sam's here. The sky's the limit.
Hey, Mom can't beat him out if don't come with hands.
Fine, I'll stay here with Sam.
What?
Just like in the war, you and me. Hey, where are you going?
This was a mistake.
Hey!
I'm sorry. Can we get out?
What?
I have soccer practice in about 40 minutes.
You're a 30-year-old man.
Yeah.
You have soccer practice?
We're in a league. We're in the playoffs. Just
okay,
stay in.
Yeah, you're in the playoffs?
Yeah, we play.
Yeah.
Dude.
My mom told me,
dude,
we would only
have to completely ignore me right now. Hello!
What?
I think it's really problematic that none of us are Native American, but we're playing Native American characters. And you know what? These costumes are straight up racist.
They're meant to signify a shift in time and place. You know, besides, it's not even your job to worry about this. Say your lines.
Excuse me?
You're an actor. You're supposed to say your lines and stand where I tell you to. That's your entire job.
That's incredibly insulting.
Isn't that the job, Charlie?
Easiest job in the world.
You know, if I could be in front of people, I can't just ignore the fact that I'm like someone of a different ethnicity.
I mean, Sam's Indian.
What? I'm wrong kind of Indian, Charlie, but nice try.
You're kidding? You could totally pass.
Really?
Fool me, I was like, what's she talking about? Sam's writing about a drag.
Oh, well, see, there you go.
It's not about look, it's about lived experience.
Well, I don't know any Native American actors. So what, am I just not supposed to write about how Native Americans are a part of this? The internment camp at Boston was also populated by the Mojave, the Chemehuevi, the Hopi. It was a convenient place to stick all of the Native people from all over the Southwest, especially after the Japanese internees built the infrastructure as slave labor.
Find someone.
And fire you?
No, not me. Maybe fire Charlie.
Hey!
I don't
want to
be here.
I wanted to be here.
What?
Oh, no, that makes sense.
Can we finish this up? And whatever the plan is fine. It's all going to be over in 4 weeks anyway. And the moral arc of history bends toward whatever. So none of us really need to care about.
Towards justice.
Exactly.
I feel like you don't even know who said that.
Okay, so Brenda, why don't you go find us a Native American actor? And then we'll do some wooden rehearsals and get them up to speed.
I need this job. I'm supposed to get braces next month.
Aren't you way too old for braces?
No, I mean, I had them. I didn't wear my retainer, and now my
okay.
Let me see.
No, guys, wait, this play is important right now. It's the 75th anniversary of Executive Order number 9066. And we've seen a lot of executive orders get tossed around recently. I mean, who knows what could happen next? Do we really think that we're so removed from a time when the president could imprison an entire group of people based solely on their race? Do we really think that we're safe? The Native Americans were the first group of people to be systematically interned by the U.S. government, a system that continues to affect them to this day. And look at Standing Rock! Native people are part of history and a part of history in the making. It's important that we tell the story. And more important than that, people are coming to see this thing tomorrow, and I don't have time to rewrite it again, according to your never-ending stream of conflicting notes.
Hey!
Oops, sorry. Listen, I gotta go to practice. So what's the plan? Are we replacing Brenda?
No, are we firing Charlie.
No!
You're not firing me. I'm in charge of this whole thing.
I'm another actor. And while we're discussing changes that should be made,
are we?
We really should address the J word. It's a racial slur?
Oh, it isn't?
Yeah, it is.
How is it a slur? It's like a nickname.
Oh, wow.
No, Charlie, yeah, no, it's a racial slur.
Then why are you having us say it?
It's historically accurate. People used it back then. I'm showing how racism is a pervasive force even among marginalized groups.
People today might not know you're using it that way.
Well, I don't think people are as ignorant as you seem to.
I don't think they're ignorant. I think they'll find it offensive.
How is it offensive? It's literally in the word Japanese.
It's all about context.
Change the line.
No! No new lines, no new actors, no unicorn shooting rainbows out of their nostrils, no nothing except what I've already written in the script, which, according to the moderator of my writer's group, is, and I quote, really interesting. And that is from the assistant literary manager of a very well-known regional theater company. So, just say your lines.
Fine.
You know what? No. I'm not doing it as written. Braces will have to wait.
Fine! Who needs you? Let's go to soccer practice. Come on, Sam.
Wait, hold on. Wait, really? Wait, you can't go.
You said you were fine with that.
Well, I don't think you'd actually quit.
Some people have principles.
Well, if you care so deeply about it, then maybe the thing to do isn't to sit back in silent protest, but to actually get up in front of people and say something.
I sign a lot of online petitions, thank you very much, and I do more. But until there's a protest that is fully inclusive of all groups and represents true intersectionality, I am not going to join them.
Okay.
Please, I thought you were going to practice.
Now, wait, oh, look, listen! The three of us, we are tiny. We're garbage as far as the guy at the top is concerned. The only thing that we have going for us is that people are showing up to see our play. So if we want to make even a little bit of difference, we have to show up too. Because that's the only way that anyone changes anything.
I'm not doing it as is.
Okay. I'll rewrite the script. Do like a whole play within a play thing, as well as turning the book. Representation is important.
Thank you.
That was really touching and beautiful, but you said practice paper by 3 and it's 2:58,
no,
so I
got... Wait, no, no, please listen to me, please.
Come on, I have to get by 3, man.
I'll be done by 3, I promise I'll be done by 3, please.
Fine.
Yeah, okay, good, okay, So
we're gonna skip to the fight?
Yeah, oh yes, let's fast forward through the fight. And then we're...
Okay, got it. You guys ready?
Thanks, guys.
This is insane!
Insane is where we live now.
Let's move!
Be serious.
I'm Canadian. They're gonna send me back to Guantanamo.
Leak.
After the wedding, we stay.
No, no, this is our home.
I have people's citizenship. Come with me.
You are being crazy.
I'm being crazy, me. We all know we're here because I'm Muslim.
Oh, she's back! Oh.
Nice tea set.
Thank you. Thank you. You've been here in
my office.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Here,
I'll pour, may I?
We have to let it stay. Alright. So, you are getting married?
Yes,
in Toronto?
Well, actually, we got married here. We're having a second ceremony there for Malik's family.
Oh, that's nice. Married twice.
Oh, a lot of my family didn't want
to
come here.
Malik? To America? Why not?
What do you think?
Can I now?
Thank you. That's nice of you.
My wife reverts to just looking at me here when she's uncomfortable. She's a lawyer. She's a partner at her firm.
I have a law degree too. Everything occurring is perfectly legal, your wife will tell you. So, please state your name.
You know our name and address.
Kathleen Marlin, and my husband is Malik Dillon, 4420 Person Drive, Los Angeles.
And your parents are from?
I was born in Toronto.
Indonesia. My in-laws received a scholarship to study at the
She didn't ask that.
No, but it's helpful, thank you. Occupation?
Well,
I'm an employee. Red flag?
My husband recently left his job as a research scientist to help a friend's startup.
Oh, what sort of startup?
Really?
It's a biotech developing gene therapy for hemophilia. That's a rare blood disorders.
And religion?
No, religion was not part of our research.
Please state your religious preference.
You can't ask that.
She can.
Refuse to answer.
Well, I am a recovering Catholic.
I'm Muslim. Boom!
Okay, you can see how
this goes. A Muslim is scared of
my
red flag, right?
Excuse me.
Bringing up the big guns, no more tea.
Why are you antagonizing them?
What?
This is a waste of time.
What?
You are barely Muslim.
I pray.
When your parents are around.
I'll pray more.
Holiday.
I'll pay more. What time is it? I'll set them right now.
Oh, Malik, get up! Malik! Be calm. Islam needs peace. Show them that. Resist being clever.
She's gonna get the Muslim registry for us to sign.
If they make you sign, I'll sign too. It's my right. I'll insist.
I love you, Kathy.
I love you too, dummy.
Where were we?
What?
Oh, yes, research.
Yes. My husband lost his temper back there, but that gate agent was extremely disrespectful. What about her?
Toronto Star, July 3rd, 1992. Malik Dillon, 14, and Jason Shaughnessy, 13, were questioned at the Wellington Fire and Rescue regarding an explosion.
Seriously?
Don't respond.
I want to respond.
Go ahead, Mr. Dillon.
You're a teen geek, and you read flammable on a container.
They were curious kids, budding scientists.
I see.
No, you don't, because it's science. I beg again. You get a tin container, you put it on the bottom, and a bottle of air freshener on the top, and spray it with WD-40.
WD-40?
It accelerates the fire.
But that's common knowledge.
We ended up tearing a small hole in the can, and sent a fireball really high in the air.
They are lucky they didn't burn their faces off. Context is important. So is history. This is pre-9/11 in Canada. What they did was dangerous, but mostly to themselves.
The Shaughnessys, your friend's parents, they were called into question by the police regarding an incident involving a pipe bomb.
Okay, that.
And actually, you stopped making fun of that
not
time.
Not a pipe
class.
Bomb in the way that you were.
I'll tell you exactly how that pipe bomb was.
Something to hide wouldn't be so. Wouldn't be like my husband.
Jason's parents had a shotgun load machine in their parents' basement. And everyone's scared for crying out loud. Our soon-to-be new home?
No, that is not.
We're kids with easy access to gunpowder. So we get those copper pipes we get from those sprinkler heads and stick gunpowder in them and stick a cannon fuse. We bought cannon fuse from a store in the mall that's literally only sold. I have no idea why. But it was waterproof. And Bert was so sick, but there's enough time to walk away before I blow up in your face one time. One time we built one for a school project and blew it up. It was awesome!
Okay. Are you planning to return to Canada?
Yes, I am.
No! Listen, you have nothing but my husband's name and religion on which we're basing your suspicions.
He expressed his desire to leave, his contempt for America.
We've been more than cooperative.
We're just
You're a lawyer, right? So you're familiar with Korematsu versus the United States. The Alien Sedition Act, more recently the amicus briefs Korematsu filed after 9/11.
We're indifferent in dangerous times.
No, we are not. After Korematsu, the commission found that war hysteria, prejudice, failure of political leadership led to thousands of Japanese Americans
were treated unfairly. Reparations were made.
And clearly lessons haven't been learned.
That explosion, it didn't spread. I was grounded for a week. She lit a bottle rocket in her parents' hallway and hit the bedroom door.
Yes, I did.
You're a chemist, another red flag.
I'd like a moment with my client.
We have more questions for each of you. I'd like for you to think very carefully about where your home is.
Babe, pull it up for yourself.
What is happening?
I know what we were talking about, but I like the energy.
My only goal is to get us out on the last
night. After you're American, just leave. Go. My job.
Wait, our government only works if we participate in it.
Our government is broken, Kathy. We're too big. We're an empire, not a nation. Empires fail.
We are an experiment. You like experiments.
I'm tired of fighting. Of this.
Right. So I have a client, a Syrian man. He's a refugee. He's being deported because of an unpaid parking ticket. We think it's because he's Muslim.
Of course he's Muslim.
Shut up and listen to me. I'm using Korematsu versus United States as a precedent.
You realize somebody Muslim had a lawyer for a wife.
Fred Korematsu. Born in Oakland, Italian girlfriend, swim team, tennis team, you get the picture. Cut to 1940, Korematsu is rejected by the Navy, so he becomes a welder because he wants to help with the war effort.
Just tell me if you win.
Well, he was fired. But he got another job, and he was fired again. He wanted to work, to date girls, to fit in. He got plastic surgery on his eyelids.
Not a pleasure.
But after Pearl Harbor, when internment happened, Korematsu decided that he'd had enough. He refused to go. The ACLU took on his case.
Unless the ACLU.
Korematsu versus United States. He argued that people can't be imprisoned because of their race or religion. They deserve a fair trial. He went all the way up to the Supreme Court.
Did they win?
He was illegally imprisoned in Utah. Worked as a laborer for $12 a month. Slept in a horse stall. After he was released, he kept quiet for years. After the commission's findings, a petition was filed to have Korematsu versus United States overturned.
They win.
The judge vacated Korematsu's conviction, but she wasn't able to overturn the Supreme Court decision. Fred found his voice again after 9/11. When he saw that people were being detained without cause, he filed two briefs stating that the restriction of civil liberties has never been justified in the history of the United States. He provided examples of when the government exceeded its authority. And now he is my example. No. But he was awarded the Medal of Freedom, and the Civil Liberties Act was passed. People like Fred, like the Syrian men we're defending, they do the work so that we can keep.
So I can sit here and be interrogated?
Shakespeare's Henry VI, there's a line. Kill all the lawyers. And people laugh, but it's about killing all the lawyers so that the king can take over. We have to do the work. We have to use the law. Progress is hard. Don't let them turn you into something you're not. Don't run away. Resist. Like Fred, like MLK, like...
I don't know. But see, this... this is why I love you.
We have to stay calm. Answer their questions. And then go get on a plane to go get married again. and then we come home and resist.
It doesn't feel like home anymore.
If you fight back, you will again. We're in the right, we will win, just not today.
I don't know what to do.
They're trying to provoke you. Okay, just stay calm, answer their questions, don't embellish. They got nothing. I promise you, we're gonna be on that flight out tonight.
I'd like to apologize for my attitude.
Oh, thank you.
Two things. We will be filing a formal complaint against that gate agent.
Oh, I see.
And second, we will answer any further questions you have, providing we're on the last flight out tonight. Otherwise, I'll need to call my firm. Now.
Oh, okay. I think that won't be necessary.
Good. Shall we begin?
Thank you. Yeah.